He's okay. I'll start what I have to say since you're waiting to listen to him, not me. Okay. So, glad to see you. A lot of people from last year and lots of new people. I wrote like a speech, so I'll read it and not look at any of it. I couldn't have put this race together without the help of my family, friends, and this great community. It never ceases to amaze me how genuinely giving people are, and I hope you all realize what a difference we're making in the Wounded Warrior community. This race is very near and dear to my heart, and has become so much more than I ever thought it would. I, among others, am so completely honored to call Kelsey and Travis my family. Through their inspiration, determination, and will to live a life's purpose, we want to continue this race to give back to Wounded Warriors in any way that we can. This year, we will be providing the funds to the Travis Mills Project. This project is working in conjunction with Camp Kennebec and the Bread of Life to build an adaptional recreation facility in Maine for wounded veterans to come and enjoy with their families. This has been an idea of Travis's for a long time, and we'll do anything we can to make it come true. Money from this race will help fund ramps and adaptation are being made to facilities so that they may be fully accessible. To learn more about this, you can visit the information table. But raise awareness and inspire. Like so many of you, I had my bad days. Work was long, you got cut off in traffic, you lost your car keys, or it rained for a week straight. It is so easy to get caught up in the day-to-day stress and struggles we all face. But then I take a step back and think, is this really that bad? Have I lived today the best that I could? Travis is joined by so many other wounded warriors, like Navy EOD Taylor Morris and Army Specialist Anderson. Who choose to live the best that they can. It is important that we keep them in our prayers as they continue to adapt to this new life they have been given. I urge you to live a life of purpose. Decide every morning when you wake up that you can make today a good one. Define your purpose and make your life a story. Leave something behind. How will people remember you? Were you all that you could be? Look at this man. He is incredible. I am so inspired by his courage and determination. A true testament to a father, a husband, a brother, a son, cousin, a grandson, an uncle, a friend, and one hell of a United States soldier. I hope that as you run alongside him today, you feel truly honored. We are honored to have you here, Travis, Kelsey, and Chloe, and I'm so glad that this year brings celebration and joy to your family and ours, rather than heartache and loss. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for showing me that there is more to this life and that there really is nothing stronger than the strength of the family. I would also like to extend a heartfelt thank you to our servicemen and women who protect this country every single day. It is because of all of you that we can stand here today and celebrate these freedoms. I know that we are in the presence of so many of these men and women today, including my cousin Joshua Buck of the 82nd Airborne and Colonel Jack Moser. Can we please give them and all other service members here today a round of applause? It is so important that we remember the fallen on this Memorial Day. 4 days ago, I was given the opportunity to be in attendance at a keel laying ceremony for the DDG 1001, whose namesake will be the Michael Monsoor. Michael Monsoor was a Navy SEAL who gave the ultimate sacrifice after diving on a grenade to protect his men. As I stood there and watched his mother cry at the honor and pride she felt for her son, I could not help myself from crying. It is not fair that Michael is not here. To strike his own arc on the keel of his own ship. It is not fair that these courageous, selfless American heroes did not come home to their families. Can we please have a moment of silence for our fallen soldiers? I pray that we all remember the purpose of this race. Although it's a fundraiser, it has never been my primary goal. My primary goal is to bring people together, to raise awareness, and to pay tribute to those who came back to their families in a different condition than they left, or to those who didn't come back to their families at all. As you run, walk, or volunteer today, please keep this in mind. This is so much more than a way to raise funds, but rather a way to respect and tribute to those we are forever in debt to. To quote the man himself, Travis Mills, "Every day is a challenge, but it's not a challenge you can't overcome." Remember your armed service men and women today, as they are the reason you get to have that barbecue. Okay. Now you can. We are honored to have the First Lady of Maine, Mrs. Anne LePage, here with us today. After words from Mrs. LePage, Travis will then address you, which will be much more interesting than last. We'll then assemble at the starting line, where we'll play the national anthem and announcements from Taylor Harmon. You'll want to listen to those. A man with whom this race would not be possible without. Thank you for your patience and have a safe race today. The first male runner and the first female runner will get through. Good morning, everyone, and no, I am not running. I've got to go to a parade down in Topsom, so that's why I'm wearing a dress. But thank you all so much for coming. I'm really humbled and honored to be here today with Travis and his family and his friends. When Dean LeChance and the Bread of Life Ministries came to me to talk about Travis's dream of creating a year-round recreational facility right here in Maine, I couldn't wait to be a part of this project. After Paul was elected governor and I chose my mission of supporting our military men and women in uniform and their families, I've had the opportunity to meet some truly amazing people along this journey. And Travis, I have to say, you're probably the most inspirational person I've had the honor of meeting. You are a true champion among your peers. I can't thank you enough for the commitment you've made to your country, the courage you've shown all Americans, and the loyalty you express for all your brothers and sisters in arms. Whether it's pounding nails at Camp Kennebec or using my position as First Lady of Maine to champion this cause and bring awareness to your dream, I pledge to you today, I'll do whatever I can to make your vision a reality for you and all those servicemen and women who have given so much of themselves to protect my freedoms and freedoms around the world. Thank you so much, and God bless all of you.
Oh, I gotta hold really close. Okay, hey, good morning.
Good morning.
All right, awesome. So, a few things. As I start my speech out, I thought, at the capital of Michigan, I'm not professional at this. That's kind of, I work on it, but if I mess up, please just set the baseline that it's gonna be horrible. There's a couple things I'm gonna cover here. Thanks for coming out. This is gonna be a great camp they're setting up. I got to meet Dean and George, and George is real serious, so don't joke around too much. Looks at you with serious faces, stop it. But these guys, you know, just heard a conversation between Kelsey's Uncle Danny that he was having, or they were talking about this camp I wanted to start. I had the best experience up in Colorado, in Breckenridge, where I started snowboarding and monoskiing with my wife, and I thought, wow, this is pretty inspiring. I never in a million years would have thought that after losing both arms and both legs, that I would be up snowboarding and monoskiing. Then I've done running and hand cycling. They have ways to get fish and tubing and all this great things that you can still actually accomplish with the invitations and with this. So what today the fundraiser is for is going to be a phenomenal. I got to keep moving around real quick because my balance is, the wind's blowing. It's okay. But anyway, so. So what this run is for, you know, I think it's great. I think it's going to be a phenomenal place up there. I'm going to go and visit, obviously. We have some people planning on coming out and visiting in August for a day from the hospital already, and they're all excited about it too. Now, about me, I'm from Michigan originally, so go Red Wings in case you meet me, Stanley Cup. I'm going to throw it out there. I know. I get it. But anyway, I also like to make the announcement that my wife and I are 95 to 99% sure we're actually going to move to Maine. And we're definitely excited, so thanks for being here. It's gonna be a great day. And luckily, just the last thing, I paid my father-in-law just enough. I thought I went a little short on him. I didn't mean to. I just didn't have enough money in my wallet to not bring pieces to my running legs. Well, it was enough. So you got a spicy McChicken, 99 cents, right? $1.06. So I'm not going to be running, but I will be walking with everybody. And if you guys pass me, don't feel bad. It's okay. I'll accept it today. Like I said, hey, thanks for coming out. This is going to be a great event. And let's get the run walking there, however we're going to do it. And if anybody has a wheelchair and I want to use it, like one of my faster ones that I have, like, souped up, you let me know. Not that fast. I'm just kidding. Anyway, happy to stay, everybody. Here we go.